Hey Dad, Peter yelled. There's this guy on the line from North Queensland, and he wants to know if he can come down and stay for a few days. What's his name? I asked, trying to give myself a little space to think. James, Peter said. James who? Johnny James. Another young lad from South Australia, George Padigas by name, had come up to see us for a couple of weeks about 3 years ago, and he's still here. What's all that racket coming from the house? I exclaimed as Rosalie and I grabbed the groceries from the back of the car. And why are our neighbors conversing with each other all the way down the street? I questioned. Hey, shut that thing down, I screamed. What's going on here? I continued. Having just a jam, Pete piped up. We've only just moved into this neighborhood of Malulabar, and they're out there talking about chasing us out of the town, and you're having a what? Jam, Dad, Pete repeated himself again. How come the fridge has still got food in it? I asked Rosalie sometime later as I was digging around looking for a little snack. They're all fasting, she exclaimed. Yes, she said. They won't be eating for a few days. They just want to seek the Lord and find His will for the group. Well, that should put us in front at least for a while, I commended, chomping on a chicken leg. America, America, they were all calling out as they came in running together. They want us to go and cut a record in New York.
I'm Howard Finster. I'm just a simple man with a simple message.
Hi. My name's Freddy.
Hey Freddy.
How are you?
Fine.
Hi. My name's Eddie. Freddy and Eddie. Teddy's are still in the store. And spaghetti stayed at home. Where's this going to? What town?
What town?
Where did you come from? Yeah. Where did this camera
come from? It's all over. This is the state of Illinois.
State of Illinois.
Illinois, yeah. Oh, okay. And it's like all the way from down under where? What time do you guys perform?
3:00.
You know, you just play, right?
Yeah, we play.
Whenever they tell you to. Who's the, which one? Are you the drummer?
Back in the camp.
It's crazy the time I saw you guys before. You guys still on a good show.
One gig we were playing on a place called the Gold Coast Australia.
You're not going to tell them that.
Yeah, I'm going to tell them. Just before we started, there was all these birds in the trees making all
millions
this noise.
Of like birds.
What happened was we got on the drums and started playing. And as soon as we hit the first drum, all these birds took off in the air and flew and And they pooed all over us.
There must have been a million birds went to the toilet all at once. All of the band. It was like a shower of bird droppings.
The biggest lie that's ever come out of this world, that being a Christian's boring or being a Christian's for wimps, you cannot have any fun. You got to walk around like you've been sucking on lemons all day. And straight away, you can't be a teenager and have fun. We're getting across to the young people of America that they're the ones that are missing out if they don't know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior on the most energetic, the most fun, the most fulfilling, the most rewarding adventure, and that's following Jesus Christ.
Very energetic is the word. Energetic is the key.
Welcome back, the Newsboy.
Smooth. by hidden fears, always stuck in neutral gears, till I gave the driver's seat away. Take my life and make it real, turn the key and take the wheel, push the throttle through the floor, evermore, evermore, evermore.
Talking about turning your world upside down. You know, God doesn't want you to be turned upside down by the world. He wants you to turn the world upside down. Stick around. This is going to be a great program.
Waking up the neighbours, you know what I mean, just annoying people and getting our equipment confiscated by the police and stuff like that. And so, yeah, so we're always in a lot of trouble. We're pretty young when we started, and so it's just kind of like
a lot of enthusiasm.
Yeah, a lot of youth groups and that have guys in the youth group that have bands and they practice all the time and try to play at all the youth group functions. And well, that's how the Newsboys sort of started in that sense. You know, we started out playing pubs and clubs, you know, and doing our own thing, and then as our convictions grew stronger, then all of a sudden we found that it was like a foul taste in our mouth. You know what I mean? It's like, man, this is not where we're meant to be. We're not reaching anybody here, and we weren't knocking any other bands that were doing it, that were Christian bands playing in the pubs and scene. But we knew for us we had much more of a powerful anointing on our lives, and with John speaking a gift where we couldn't use that in a pub or a club, it was time to use it, to go where we could use it and to not bury our talent, so to speak.
The title sums it up. You know, as Christians, it tells us in, I believe, Romans chapter 1, verse 16, it gives us great advice there. It says to all of us, you know, for we are not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, because it's the power of God for the salvation of everyone who believes. And we just really wanted to get across the people that we are the Newsboys, as being Christians, as having the good news. We don't want to hide it under a bushel, but we're proud that we're Christians, and we're not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ.
People are getting into music like ours, and it doesn't just because it's Christian. I think a major problem is a lot of friends at school that kids have at school are not educated with Christian music. And when we say crossing over, it's more the term of people, our fans, and people watching Fire By Night to get a Newsboys tape and to give it to friends that are into that style of music, or any other Christian band who is a good band, give it to them, and that's sort of crossing over in a sense. You're getting it to them people, but not changing the message, leaving the same message there and the same power and the anointing of God there, but cross that tape over, you know what I mean? You do the crossing over, yeah? We don't have to do it, you know what I mean? We just want people to come to our concerts to where we can lead them to Jesus Christ. That's our part of the deal. That's our part of the bargain where, you know, when we're talking about that, it's more It's not called selling out, it's called, you know, taking the cross to the people.
The ministry time isn't something, Peter, that we just take lightly. We play music because we love playing music, but we use music as a tool to get people's attention and, if need be, respect, and put them in a place where they're willing to listen. And then when it comes time to present your feel, it's kind of like the whole night is heading in that direction for that time when you can get up and share the good news. And man, knowing Christ is good news. And I know the guys will be backstage while we're sharing. They'll be praying and just believing for the Lord to speak to lives. And we make a point in our show where we take time out to present the gospel of Jesus Christ that to young people, and not only to teenagers, but to adults, anyone, that the gospel of Jesus Christ isn't just an old book, that it's relevant for today, for tomorrow, forever. It's applicable for people today, right here.
John James has got no hair at the moment. He's thinking of going on TV and being a spokesman for like a Compliment or something. He ain't got much hair on his head, but he likes it and he looks good and he still loves Jesus, so I guess that's all that counts.
Yeah, it's hairspray. If you want hair like this, I've been using this special Helsinki formula. Spray it on my head, doing a treatment over 6 months. And look at the result. All from the men.
It's called an eight ball.
Be still and know.
Okay. Some white. Little baby on the way.
His glory and grace.
You know what they say?
What?
God good, devil bad.
Okay! These boys, live at church.
No slapping every prayer. Lord, thank you for saving us. Lord, just everything you're doing in our lives. Just your protection, Lord, as we come to stage tonight.
To my body. It will not be removed until after the show, and it's quite a process. Actually, Peter Furler is involved in the process. It's some kind of genetic kind of scraping, skin scraping.
It's
goes
on. Called a base club cement.
Oh, there we go. Okay, now Peter has just exited the building. He's actually the first one on stage during the intro take. Because he plays kind of a drum track. Do you like how I'm kind of narrating you through this whole kind of series of events? Peter's actually the first on. The IntelliBeams have just started to go off. Pretty soon there's a bass line that comes in. And there it is. Peter's going to start playing here in just a minute. We're going to get ready to go on stage. We're going to do our second show of the night. It's 11:25 p.m. at night. And it's just starting.
You think it's time? The boy can't
Get James on the light switch, because every gig, I can't help feeling the light switch.
It's just a thing I've got. I got to know what this switch does.
Every gig we go to, we're sitting on the toilet.
Right? I'm sitting on the toilet somewhere.
Just here, minding my own business, doing my own thing. Right? Doing my thing.
Right?
And next bit, the lights go out. It's black. Every gig we go to, I call out, James! It's always James, filling with the light switch.
Before we present the award, I thought it might be fun to play a little game. I've been in the studio recently with the Newsboys and was very surprised to learn that only 3 of them are Australian and 2 of them are American. Since the accents are a little different, I thought it would be fun for everyone watching tonight to guess where each Newsboy's from just by hearing the accents, right? Are you ready? And I should say this game will be easier for our home viewers since tonight's show has been closed captioned for the accent impaired. So, here we go, Newsboy number 1.
Hi.
Australian.
Right.
Australian.
God bless America.
American.
God bless the state of Kentucky.
South American.
Oi, enough yabber before the seppos upstairs start grizzling.
Your bass player quit.
So who here plays the bass? You play the bass?
Well, it's actually my own version of a bass. It's sort of homemade.
Well, go get it.
I'll need to know where the janitor keeps his...
Just go. Help him, somebody.
Okay.
Shine before all men. Let them see good works today. Let them glorify.
in Australia, out of Sydney somewhere. Anyway.
I like the part where you spin around in that.
Oh yeah?
It looks like a saucer or some flower or something like
that. Yeah, those flowers are very cool. They're native to Australia.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Cool. Well, anyway, I know that you guys rock live, and I've got to see you several times, and I think you got some footage of some live stuff.
Oh yeah, cool. Yeah, hopefully we can run that soon. We take a lot of pride in our live show. We think that it's really important. You know, we love what we do. We love music, but we love performing and putting across a good show. I think when we do that, you've got it. You know, you get the respect of the kids.
Mm.
You know, you get a little more integrity as to what you're saying, and you got a platform, so people listen to what. You know, the guts of what you got to say. So let's roll some live footage and get an idea of what the show's like.
Yeah, our guys we have now, they're my best friends, and that's what you hear on this new record. It's a bunch of guys, six guys in studio that are best friends working out a record, you know, and trying to make a record.
With the release of the new album, Take Me to Your Leader, the Newsboys are bringing their brand of alternative Christian rock to an entirely new level.
Best record we made so far. You know, one thing we always do, no matter how good our last record sold, we always try and just make a better record. You know, that's what we definitely did this time.
In addition to their numerous industry awards, Grammy nominations, and the success of the two previous albums, the new release finds them exploring new territory and continuing to grow as a band.
You know, we're one band that's just trying to get better, you know, and do our best at that, get better as players and as a team and as songwriters and everything that we do.
I think this new album's definitely a step, in the direction that the band's heading, you know, and that's pretty exciting.
Mom and Dad, I'm fine, how are you? Join a small circus, that much is true. I'm a little malnourished, but try to relax. Could you find a better photo for the milk carton bags in morning?
Newsboys singer, songwriter, and drummer Peter Furler has once again teamed up with producer Steve Taylor and brought in engineer Tom Lord Alge to bring a different approach into the recording process.
The teamwork of the band has been, I think that's probably the biggest MO of this record is it's a band record, you know.
It's like we just got in with six guys in the studio and just bashed it out, you know, just went in, hammered it. We were all in the studio together. Some of the tracks just went down live, and it was just more of what you see on stage.
After hitting the road in early 1995 and playing over 250 live shows on the road, the Newsboys have taken their dynamic show and hard-edged music to hundreds of thousands of people worldwide.
Yeah, so that's some live footage. We've got some. Actually, our live show's expanded a lot. You know, have you seen our show recently?
I saw the one at NASA.
Oh, okay, yeah. Well,
where you walk out of that spaceship.
Yeah, well, since then we've got, you know, we have these, like, three spaceship things that we ride on and come out of the...
No kidding.
Out of the ceiling, yeah. They come down. That's all pretty corny, but it's fun. It's a bit like Parliament, you know, if you've ever been...
Oh, Parliament the Funkadelic.
Yeah, so we have that.
Absolutely.
And we have, and then we have these big video walls, round video walls.
Yeah.
And up on there, like, we just project stuff during the songs, and we project, like, that leader video, and, and while we play it, we sync up. We play exactly to time of the video.
You're making a movie, or you have made a movie with Steve Taylor?
Yeah, and some of that footage is up, is in our live show, too. Yeah, we made a movie, Yeah, it's just a crazy movie. It goes for 60 minutes.
Tell people might not know exactly who Steve Taylor is. How'd that get involved?
Oh yeah, well that? Steve's just a good friend of the band, and yeah. he helps write some of the lyrics, always has in the past, and may continue to do so. And he's just a really creative guy, and we just
definitely.
Oh, he produced our last record. So in the studio, we just started talking about the idea of music videos and that, and then we just sort of started thinking, why don't we just like make a movie? As Christians, we feel a little inadequate as sharing our faith. We feel dull. We don't feel like we have, although we know that God loves us and we know we're saved. We understand grace. We know the beauty of the gospel. Sometimes we don't feel it. Sometimes it's just the truth.
Yeah, there you go.
Drink three cups of coffee and get really wild. She twitch and move and shake her head. She'd lie on the floor, pretend she were dead. She was normal, but at the same time.
I think we're a band we constantly evolve, because we get sick of ourselves really quick. We see a videotape of us playing live a month ago, and we sort of cringe.
Their dedication to improvement, both in their music and in their personal lives, allows the Newsboys to remain one of Christian rock's most influential bands over the last 10 years.
Some bands make a record and they feel like, wow, how am I going to beat that? Or how am I going to, they feel like they really excelled. We haven't had that feeling yet.
While their alternative sound pulls in a strong crossover audience, it's the insight in their lyrics that defines these thoughtful, world-renowned rockers
as evident in their latest album, Step Up to the Microphone.
Our music stems a lot from conversations that we have together on the bus, on the road. We spend a lot of time together. And of late, especially in the last couple of years, we've been reading a whole lot more.
Like C.S. Lewis.
Philip Yancey.
Also Francis Schaeffer.
And we'll discuss the things we've read and get excited about them and start seeing how these things have been have affected our lives. And of course, that's what artists do. They express what they're going through and how they see the world. And our worldview is through the eyes of Christ, let's hope. And so these things that we've been reading and talking about end up on our records.
Early on in their career, they had very simple messages. You know, their songs were, had lyrics like, "Stand up for Jesus," "I've got the joy." And now, 10 years later, I'm seeing them explore some of the things that, you know, affect us.
You know, young people are not dumb. They're looking for reality, they're looking for answers. Who is this Jesus that walked the earth? Why do I believe in him and not in Muhammad or Buddha? What is it? And I think once we start to realize what we believe, why we believe it, it makes for a stronger Christian.
Striving to be stronger Christians has been a lifelong journey for the Newsboys, all of whom come from solid religious backgrounds. But it hasn't been easy.
One of the hardest things for a group of guys to do is to be able to talk about how they feel about things.
I was really ashamed of my dad when I was probably 15, 16 years old because of him being a pastor. And I said to him one time, I got fed up and I said, what are you doing this for? You know, you're going out in the middle of Australia preaching to Aborigines and, you know, feeding people and that. What does it all come, you know, what does it come to? And, you know, I remember him saying, this is for the kingdom. And just this heaviness fell on me. And then I think that was a turning point on one of them trips where I started to look at them and I respected them because I knew that if these guys had given up everything for this God and this cause, then I've got to look into it further than that.
I think that's the cool thing about the band and what we've been going through the last couple of years is that we've had to go back and ask ourselves why we believe what we believe, because a lot of us were in similar situations. Little brother, little sister, I'm the one we go out of our ordinary self, stepping out to what the people say.
These guys are just, they're great guys, and I think people wonder that sometimes with artists, you know, is it a real thing or is it just a game, you know, and I can honestly say that all of these guys are very true to what they, you know, represent.
I travel with them a lot, and I haven't noticed any particular change. They remain to be, in my eyes anyway, just honest, humble, practical, easy to get on with guys.
The Newsboys remain a tight-knit group of very special friends, which perhaps explains much of their success.
We're definitely a team, and I think that's what makes it good, because if you got one of us separately, you know, we're not nearly as strong as you know, the five put together, and then it makes this other entity, you know. And I think that comes across on the stage.
It seems like everything we do for fun in the band, we all do together. I mean, dirt biking is probably one of the best things, because it's parallels so much with what we go through in life. This past weekend, I went on a trip. So we went about 75 miles through Colorado. And when I got stuck in a few parts, you know, our crew guy, Steve, came back to help me make it up the last part. And I was just getting exhausted. I was feeling like I was going to collapse, you know? And like, the more I thought of it after, you know, thinking of the trip, I was like, man, this is like, this parallels so much to what our band is like when one guy's not doing good, the others are always there to help him, you know, and to help him get through tough spots, you know. Or if we're in the studio and, you know, and I'm not, you know, I'm messing something up and Pete's there to help me guide through a track of a song, you know, it's so great. I think it's really good.
And it is this camaraderie that helps the Newsboys stay rooted in humility.
Yeah, look at me, you know, I mean, I'm not really, I'm not your rock star type. I feel more of a youth group leader. It keeps me on the ground, you know.
You think, well, who am I, who are we to be role models, you know? It's like, you know, I'm just an ordinary guy, just like the guy on the street that happened to be placed in this situation.
But the Newsboys are role models, to millions of kids all over the world. And it's a responsibility they take very seriously.
In some ways, it's very rewarding being a role model because, you know, you don't realize how easy it is to make a fan's week just by saying a simple hello. You know, it's a great feeling.
I think as people put in this situation, we need to say, okay, well, we have to set a standard for our lives.
And they have set standards, which they adhere to, despite the temptations in their daily lives, in the apparent paradox between their look and their lifestyle.
Nothing is necessarily sort of planned out and, you know, I'm going to look like this to reach this generation or something. I think it's just the way we are. I mean, we're a part of this generation.
And as part of their generation, their music speaks directly to their generation. And their message is pure and simple.
When you start falling in love with Christ, you start falling in love with His creation and with His people, with humanity.
Yeah, the true heart of God is humility and grace and mercy and compassion for your fellow man.
Yeah, he tells us to go and preach the gospel to all men and to be a light to the world. And you can't do that if you're, you know, staying in your own little cliques.
And so I would like to challenge kids to just get a little more, look a little more outward and look for those windows of opportunity to give of yourself, of your time and of your money. I would like to encourage kids to do that a little more.
This is something that really does impact the youth, you know, step out of their circle and to see the world in a different, under a different light.
Shine, let it shine before all men. Let them see good works of men. Let them glorify the Lord.
They've been together for over 10 years, traveled the world, produced 7 albums, 2 gold albums, earned 3 Grammy nominations, and played before one of the largest crowds ever to see a Christian rock concert. Yet despite all their success, the Newsboys remain steadfast in their conviction to their faith, their fans, and their music.
It's always a challenge, and there's always somewhere to go. There's you're never really standing still in your walk with Christ.
To some people, we are entertainment, you know. To some people, we are church when we have a show. To some people, we're a great band who plays music, you know, that they enjoy.
It's always evolving, you know. I think as Christians, we're evolving. We sort of challenge each other on that. And as musicians and songwriters, you know, it's always evolving. It's, you stop learning when you're dead, you know.
What were you thinking? I got a right to ask. Is there a reason other than your past? A great pretender, why was I the last to see through your skin? Is there a chance you'll ever change? It's always the same, you're always to blame. Is there any way around it? I can't say. You walked out on her, you plan to be free. I'm trying not to point the finger, but it's killing me. What were you thinking? What were you thinking of me? And did you see what they wrote on the family tree? I know it's over, it's all in the past. I need to forgive you if I'm so lost. Will I ever change? It's always the same, you're always to blame. Is there any way around this? I can't say. You walked out on her, you planned to be free. I'm trying not to point the finger, but it's killing me. Is there any way around this? I can't say. You walked out on her, you planned to be free. I'm trying not to point the finger, it's always the same. We'll be right back.
she's on the should be known. And there'll be more than once a fall. Everybody gets a shot. It'll cost you everything you got. Should be known. Do you really want to know? She tries a little denial. Rolls her eyes like a jaded reptile. True, false questions make her uptight. Opposites attract, so they both must be right. What if there's someone up there? Shrugs it off with a don't know, don't care. Hopes to God he doesn't exist. But ignorance is his lesson just now. Hold on, if the truth be known, a truth is more than to each his own. If the truth be known, do you really wanna know? Everybody gets a shot, it'll cost you everything you got. If the truth be known, do you we'll be right back.
Clap your hands together, this is a Brazilian jumping song. It's gonna be okay, I know how it ends.
It's nothing that I ate, and it didn't come from skating with Holy Roller. It's an early warm sun, it keeps my love alive. It's so hard to define, never mind. It's just a spirit thing, it's just a holy nudge, like a circuit judge in the brain. It's just a spirit thing, it's here to guard my heart. It's just a little hard to explain. It pushes when I quit, it smells a counterfeit. Sometimes it works a bit like a teleprompter. But when it's teleprompting you, I'll pray you'll let it through, and I'll help you with the how. Now it's just a spirit thing, it's just a holy nudge, like a circuit judge in the brain. It's just a spirit thing, it's here to guard my heart. It's just a little hard to explain.
All right, here we go. Give me something from the left. Woo! Now give me the right. One more time from the left. That's beautiful, but tonight in Brazil, I think it's gonna be the right.
I took the pole. But